Sometime in 1044, the Chinese invented gunpowder. Ever since then, we've been using it for terrible things. But what if we sent one of our 12,685 nukes to the moon? You may be saying, Charlie, that's a crazy idea. Who would want to nuke the moon? Well, the answer is our loving government. In 1958, the US Air Force created Project A-119. This was a plan to detonate a nuke on the moon. Obviously, this didn't happen, but what if it did? How would the blast affect us on Earth? I'm Charlie, and today we're going to look at what if we nuked the moon. Before we get into it, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? So let's go back to Project A-119. In the 1950s, the USA and Soviet Union were in a space race. And frankly, the Soviet Union was crushing the USA. They'd successfully sent their Sputnik satellite into space. So the American government thought it would be a good idea to nuke the moon. The government thought this would increase morale and show off American firepower. Would seeing the moon blow up increase your morale? I don't think so. Thankfully, this project was scrapped and then declassified in 2000. They didn't cancel it because they were worried it would harm the moon. Instead, it was because of a fear of negative public reaction. But what if 50 megatons of TNT, also known as a nuclear bomb, did go off on the moon? So that you can get an idea of how much damage this would cause, check out Hiroshima. Hiroshima was a gigantic Japanese city before it was destroyed by an atomic bomb. Well, one nuke would be the equivalent of 3,800 Hiroshima bombs. But amazingly, for a moon nuke to actually affect Earth, you would need 10 trillion megatons of TNT. That is because the moon is 384,400 kilometers away from Earth. If around 10 million megatons of TNT was used, then there would be a gigantic impact on Earth. The moon would be pushed out of the Earth's orbit, and this would cause lots of asteroids and meteors to smash into Earth. Gravity would also change, as well as our water levels, meaning our tides would flood all major cities by the sea. But it's still a good thing that Project A-119 did not go ahead. That's because it could have caused catastrophic radiation levels on the moon. Right now in Hiroshima, people are still being born deformed because of the radiation from the atomic bomb. That bomb went off in the 1940s. Back in the space race, the military had plans to colonize the moon in 1967. Of course, this did not go ahead, but they didn't know that. So, back then, they did not want to ruin the land they were planning to colonize. The moon is not protected by an ozone layer much like Earth is. This leaves it open to cosmic rays and solar flares, which could negatively impact the planet. This means there is space radiation. And detonating a nuke on the moon would simply add to that radiation. The moon has lots of craters because of meteorites which have smashed into it. So, detonating a nuke would pretty much cause a gigantic crater, kind of like the ones the moon already has. This crater would likely be around 8 miles in diameter. If it was detonated on the lit side of the moon, then your eye may be able to see it. But if the nuke went off on the dark side of a new or crescent moon, your eye would probably see a blip of light for a few seconds. But it's also a logistics nightmare. If you try and transport a nuclear bomb to the moon and the rocket carrying it blows up on launch, then you will damage the Earth a lot. In fact, pretty much an entire country would be ruined. Of course, a nuke wouldn't blow up an entire country like the USA, but it would radiate at least 50% of it, meaning everyone would be very sick in the country. You'd also obliterate your launch facility, wasting billions or trillions of dollars. And if the rocket blows up while it's already pretty high in the sky, then you could cause an EMP. This is also known as an electromagnetic pulse. This would disable all electronics, causing an economic crash and technologies to fail. Telephone and internet signals would cease, and streetlights would be blown out. Hard drives and digital electronics for miles would also be fried. So, while detonating a nuke that we have on the moon may not cause too much trouble to Earth, we still should not try it. Too much could go wrong, and it's also pretty pointless. Instead, we should focus on trying to get to the moon and build a lunar base. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner. Would you want to live on the moon? If you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. There'll be a link to that on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.